Eddie and Amy Frank designed the Mongolian trek through time with the most authentic wilderness experience in mind. Following ancient trails into a wilderness that the nomads and their herds have traversed for millennia.
This is for our book.
Now we're climbing a very famous mountain in this area. It's called Shvet Khargan. And this is a sacred mountain for the local Tuvan people that came down here about 150 years ago, and they're shamanistic people. So they attach spiritual value to this mountain. So we will have this in our presence, this mountain in our presence, the sacred mountain in our sacred presence for 3 days, which is really nice. And where we're ultimately going is around this ridge where the rocks end. That's the first collection of rock etchings that we'll see. These date back quite a few thousand years. In this particular area, they go to the Bronze Age. Bronze Age is about 3,800 years ago, 4,000 years ago. They don't know much about the people themselves, but they were able to date these based on the style that they were able to identify in other parts of this mountain. The sites that have the most artwork tend to be the ones that have the longest and broadest views.
It is said that in the land of the eternal blue sky, you can experience four seasons of weather in a day. Tusker's all-weather tents and waterproof bags will help insulate you from bright sun, soft mist, possibly rain, and in the mountains, maybe even snow.
We started at around 9:30 and it was raining quite a bit. Now the sun's broken out. I mean, this is just incredible. I don't think any amount of pictures are going to do justice to this place. And you just find yourself a hot rock and try and dry your stuff out before you head on out to camp.
It's a magical moment when you can eat lunch in a place such as this. And that's exactly what we're going to be doing right now.
Each trek includes an experienced wilderness chef who serves up delectable fresh-cooked meals 3 times a day.
We got the Kazakh guys singing Kilimanjaro songs. That's because Alex been teaching them. Really nice cross-cultural stuff.
Each trek is led by a professional Tusker guide, a certified wilderness first responder, equipped with safety provisions for any contingency.
No adventure is really an adventure without surprises. And certainly on this trip, surprises did happen.
Don't move. Ravi fell in a mud hole. Okay. And he landed on his shoulder. And I examined his shoulder and he's dislocated his shoulder. So as you know, as well as first responders, you're not allowed to reduce a shoulder that has been dislocated through direct impact. So I've examined him, he has distal sensory and circulation.
Okay.
So he has no impaired movement in his hands or fingers. So he doesn't have any circulation cut off.
Right. You know?
So as long as we can keep him stable and pain-free, that's the plan right now.
Okay.
And I'm gonna call Record to see if they can advise me to do anything else right now. We'll also call OV to get a vehicle sent out. So we can probably have him in a hospital
this evening
or by tomorrow morning.
Okay.
I'm going to call Ripcord, the evacuation company, and consult with one of their doctors as to the best course of action, at least something that I can do, guided by them. His good shoulder is rounded as per normal, and his bad shoulder has this sort of step in it, as if his arm has gone under his shoulder bone. I've seen that before. Okay, we're gonna try and fix this, Robbie. Can you straighten your arm out a bit like that? Yeah. Don't lift you this arm. Can we move a little more?
Yeah, move it higher.
Just the direction I'm pushing you in. Don't lift it. Don't lift anything. Just rest into my hand here. Yeah, that's it. Still feel any pain?
Some pain.
Okay, tell me when it hurts. It shouldn't hurt.
Yeah, no.
A little bit hurts? So just tell him he can almost touch his shoulder, but then it hurts.
He can almost touch his shoulder with his fingertips, and then that's when it starts to hurt. So part of my job in this was to communicate with Ripcord so that Eddie could have both hands free to work on Robbie.
I've got you. Huh?
No, it's starting to hurt now.
Okay, just relax on my arm here. There we go, that's it. That's what I want you to do. Doesn't that look better?
Yeah, the tip disappeared.
Disappeared.
Once it was reduced, Ravi was in hardly any pain at all. He was laughing and joking and felt 100% better.
The urgent part of this is over.
Oh, great, thank you.
Yay!
We have reduced your shoulder. It is not dislocated anymore.
Thank you.
He was probably the easiest guy to deal with because he had faith in us, and having faith in your healer is the best form of healing.
Thanks, Mel.
So Ravi is able to continue on the trek with us.
We're on the banks of the Tsagangol River. We're about probably 5 kilometers from our campsite, and we're going to be heading straight up this river valley to camp at the foot of that ridge over there, another 15 kilometers upriver tomorrow. We're in the Altai Mountains, the Mongolian side of the Altai Mountains, probably some of the most beautiful mountains I've ever traveled through, especially on horseback.
Amy and I discovered this particular part of Mongolia, and we've been running trips here every year for the last decade. It's a spectacular part of the world to run trips in.
The last time I rode was in my teens, and Eddie said, yeah, just go for it.
Okay, let's go.
Raced up and down the hill and galloped straight from 0 to 60.
And Eddie wins by nose.
It was incredible.
Tusker Trails Mongolia. Rise to the challenge. The adventure.